My dear friends, so our spiritual life, the renewal of our spiritual life takes place in three stages. That's what we heard in the introduction. That is, God has created every man to have life in all its fullness. No manager or no owner builds a company for failure, for destruction, or to become loss. The owner, the factory, has a vision to produce something, produce for the world, produce money, produce economy, produce work for money. Yes, you and I are sent, the human beings are sent into the world, join with the Master, the Lord God, who is the source of life, and to give life to this world. That's why today in the Gospel, Jesus speaks so many things. We cannot explain all that in a very short time. In first reading, he says, choose life. It's up to you. Choose life. In our life, many things will go wrong. We should not get upset with that. Try to correct it and go ahead in life. In our life, many things will not work as we desire. The enemy will come and show the situation and make us to get upset. No, we need not get upset. This is life. But we can do three things. That's what the Lord says. If you wish to follow me, take up your cross and follow me. We take only this one sentence. Choosing life. So the first thing the Lord says, if you wish to follow me, following the Lord demands that we have a desire, a wish, a longing. If you want to be in the presence of God, that doesn't come, okay, I like to do. It's not unliking. It's a wish. In another translation, my Bible says, those who desire to follow me, those who long to follow me, what do they? So following the Lord demands longing. If you want to follow the Lord, before following, you should have the longing for the Lord. If you don't have the longing for the Lord, you can't follow him. We read in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 27, Jesus is telling them, the disciples, one of you is going to deny me, betray me. Judas knows that he is a chosen disciple. Judas knows he is one of the 12. Actually, there were 72 people came to follow the disciple life. But out of 72, he chose 12 who are very close to him. And among these 12, the only person to whom he gave all his finance was Judas. So you can imagine how Judas was so important. It is Judas who went and bought everything. Though God had given such a wonderful position to him, what happened? He's with Jesus. Jesus, with a broken heart, he says, one of you are going to betray me. Judas knows very well. He's going to betray. He's asking, Master, is it I? The Master says, yes, to whom I am going to give the bread. What is this bread? Few minutes ago he says, this is my body broken for you. I have come to give my life for you. This is my blood which is poured out for you. Understand my love for you. But nothing goes into the mind or the heart of Judas, because already he had sold himself to the high priest. He has sold himself to the lust for money. If your heart is, that's why Jesus said, you cannot serve two masters at a time. Either you have to hate one. If you don't have the hate, you can't have the love for another. Sometimes we say, okay, I will not do this. Nothing will work. You will do the same thing. Unless there is hatred for certain things which are not of the Lord, that will be part of you one day. Jesus said, he will hate one and hold on to the another. He will throw away one and hold on to the another. Many of the times we compromise. We don't have the guts to hate and cut it off. Those elements which are not of the Lord. No, I don't need it. I don't need this relationship. I don't need this kind of talking. No, as long as this kind of talking is part of me, I will never grow in the Lord. I may decide to grow in the Lord, but the Lord will not grow in me. Because for God to grow, a wish, a longing, a desire has to be there. To follow the Lord demands a hunger, a thirst, a desire to follow Him, only Him. In other words, to follow Him, you have to hate and cut off all those elements which are not pleasing to the Lord. Jesus said in John chapter 15 verse 2, I am the vine, you are the branches, and what will my Father, the gardener, do? Do you know that? He will come and see the branches. How the branches are? They are growing so nicely. They are growing so green, wild. They are looking so beautiful. But God has not made the grape garden to look beautiful. Did he create to look beautiful? For what did he create? To bear much fruit. So to bear fruit, the vine dresser will come and he will see the branches are going wild green. He will bring the scissor. He will cut. The branch will be crying, what's wrong with you? I'm looking so beautiful. I have grown so nicely. He says, if you have to bear fruit, if you have to fulfill the purpose of being the vine, this is the process. And next time when he comes, where it is cut, from there the branch comes. Branches of the fruits. That's what Jesus meant. If you desire to follow me, to follow him demands the desire. Without having the desire, which means only I need him, choose. I want, choose means what? Now I have two things. Either I can have this or that. If I have this, I have to throw it away. Suppose both are opposing each other. Suppose I am here, the water is there. Water is supposed to remain here. If I pour this water, what will happen? This is not good for to pour it on the Bible. So what I have to do? Now, if I keep, and then suppose there is no place, If I leave it, it is going to leak. Then what I have to do? I have to close it. I have to throw away the water. If the water should not leak. As long as the leakage is there, as long as the water is there, always danger. So what I do? I remove the water. I am now comfortably, I am safe. Means desiring demands, choosing that one which I want. Choosing that one I want demands cut off all that is opposing this one. If you choose this life, you have to desire. To have desire means hate everything that opposes this, what I desire.